This is Absinthe, my wife bought her from a friend of hers who was selling off her dolls. And for a while now, Absinthe has been self-conscious of the man bulge problem that I've spoke of in the past. Athena got a soft bust torso for her, so I will show the video of putting the two together. So yeah, we're gonna have some fun now. You gotta remove the arms. And we'll remove the neck peg, which on these Obitsus, you just push this little silver pin through. So I generally just choose a smaller screwdriver. You don't need to push it all the way through, that might cause you more grief than necessary. Just push it part way through, which removes the peg from this little eyelet. And then I just put it back in for now. And go ahead and separate the torso. It's probably going to come off from the bottom. This is going to get cut anyways. So I can cut a little lower and work from there. Best for precision cuts to use a hobby knife. For this cut, I'm just going to go ahead and use a regular box cutter. This might be a bit gruesome. I don't really necessarily like doing this to my dolls. I'm just kind of, no! What terrible things am I doing? My poor girls. And then part will come off a bit easier. That will eventually pop out of there. It's just a ball in a socket. You can see they use a screw to hold it together. Take out the screw if you need to make it easier. They might have used something to warm it up, but there we go, I got the part out. Nice, soft, squishy little torso there. Force that back into there so that we can show a comparison of how the body is built underneath the torso. Just realized I'm going to need another piece for this. This is the top of a two-part soft bust right there. And it separates from the top as well as the bottom. Slightly different from this. So what I'll do is I'll pull the innards out of this because we're going to need that for the new bust piece. And now this essentially requires two bodies to do, but people are always selling parts, so it's not necessarily that difficult to get a hold of the parts. You just gotta keep an eye out. The difference here is this has two ball joints, whereas this has a little pin part of the socket. This part will also come out of the center here. So then that can all be viewed as to the very little difference between them. The real difference is just how it comes apart up at the top there, based on the way it's built. So that's that. I'll move that out of the way. So we're going to need that, and the key here now is going to be just making sure we try to, for as close as we can, basically match up somewhat the lines and the curves. They don't have to be perfect, but try to be decent, and certainly don't go up any higher than this is cut. It's okay if it's a little lower, because that'll be fine. Now, perhaps the best way to do this is perhaps to try and mark it out somehow, maybe with like a pencil. The first time I tried this experiment, I used a pencil as well. So I don't know if you can see it in the camera, but I basically just tried to make a line to come close to that. So then I'll take a nice small sharp hobby knife and I'll just try and cut that line out. Careful when using a knife. You can actually probably use a scissors pretty well too if you use a nice good sharp scissors and nice steady hand. My hands are not terribly steady, but I've got pretty good confidence in this. So I'm just kind of slowly working it around. Trying careful not to force it too much. If I slip, I could destroy the bust completely. As I always say, if you're not comfortable doing this with a razor blade and you're not comfortable doing it with the scissors, but if you really want to do it, consult somebody that you think would be more comfortable, maybe a friend who's, you know, confident in their abilities, and tell them what you want to do and have them help you, you know. Or have somebody online help you that might be into the same thing. Okay. So, quite simply trimmed it down like that. I think I might make these edges just a little bit smoother, maybe. But I don't want to try to muck it up too much, because if I muck it up a little bit, then it won't be able to go back. There we go. I just nicked a little corner off it with the scissors. Makes it look a little cleaner and a little nicer. There's a little bit of staining that these always get. Do your best to try to clean them up with Mr. Clean Magic Eraser. Soft busts body do stain fairly easy, but I'm not the type of person who's all that concerned about it. I like the way the soft bust looks, so it's worth it to me to do the work. But then, yeah, pretty simple from here. Take the part off of the original soft bust's torso and fit it in there, and then it's going to go in there, and you just got to kind of stretch it around because it's going to be a little bit more of a snug fit, which personally I think is kind of a nice thing. But before I do that, we'll go to showing how this all disassembles. It looks like she's got a piece of foam in there from before. We'll take a look at that. Once you pull the bottoms of the legs out and separate, this part here just kind of separates and it's just kind of tucked in there. Okay, the bottoms pop off. Just like that. They're just sitting there like that. And you can see where the joints are attached. Very simple. For the joints, got a big flat washer built into it. Your basic screws. If you lose screws, just go to a local hardware store. Most small hardware stores, not big chains like Menards, will have extra screws of a similar size. But that part just goes right on there like that. Nothing to that. And then this should just weasel its way out of there. Like that. See, it just kind of slides in there. The hard bust has two screws here to take apart the rest of the joint piece. The soft bust has one screw and then it just kind of sits in a groove. Chances are there's not too much reason for you to ever have to take this apart. Like I said, I'm pretty confident in my abilities, so I have taken one of these apart before, just because I'm the kind of person that takes things apart to learn about them. Oh, there it goes. See? And there's the part that the body snaps into. Like I said, one screw, and then it just kind of sits in this little groove. And then these pop right off the sides, and then the little crotch piece comes down right there. So now, the bottom part of the torso is completely disassembled as well. Alright, so I've simply put the little parts, put the crotch piece in with my finger, put the legs in place, kind of held them there, then I put the other part in with a little dab of glue, and now I just got to put the screw in. Magnetic screwdriver is always a good idea. Unfortunately, the ones I'm using are not. So you just got to be steady and generally just kind of hold it up and just be careful with it. If you're patient and slow and you're holding it straight up so the screw just sits on the screwdriver, we'll do it pretty easy. Worst case scenario, you drop it, you do it again. Alright, so I got that screw in. I just changed it to a bigger screwdriver, not the one in my hand, from my little toolbox, and I got it in the first shot. Easy. No problem at all. So, that's in place. I can put the little legs back on, just the way they came off. Really easy. They just slide right in. Right into their little spot, like that. It's easy to figure out which one's which. They're not going to fit the wrong way, so you don't have to worry too much about which piece is which, but it makes it easier. Lay out the parts the way you took them off. Makes everything easier. Rule of thumb on anything you take apart or work on. Just like that, put the flat washer screw in. And it wasn't up very close, so it's not terribly good view, so. But I'll try and edit it and put it up and see where we go from there. They just squeeze the legs together, just like that, and the torso is back together. And sometimes when I'm dressing them, I have trouble with the torsos kind of popping apart. To save myself the trouble, I'm just going to go ahead and put a dab of tacky glue in this. The tacky glue will break loose if I force it, so it's not like super glue or something where it'll grip on there so hard it might break. I don't want to do that, so this is what we use, quick dry tacky glue. It's like stronger Elmer's as far as I can tell. I use it to hold my wigs on and it's easy enough to get them off, so hasn't been a problem. A little dab of the white stuff there. Yep, and the hard part about putting it in only is just the fact that it sits at a slight angle compared with the body. And it's not too hard, it's just, you know, you stab at it a couple times and then, oh, it's in, what do you know? I'll probably do the same thing on this peg to make it easier for the future, put a dab of glue in. Dab of glue right in the peg hole there. Then you just gotta kinda tuck the body rubber in there and feel for the peg. Don't put a lot of pressure in it until you're confident the peg is there. Which it did. And just like that. Squeeze the arms in. One of the only differences you notice with the torso is the shoulder rubber comes out a bit further. But obviously it doesn't cause a problem. Now she's got a pretty tight fit on there. Attach her legs. So yeah, there is our two-part soft bust Bubitsu. They're definitely slightly different than the large bust two-part soft bust. They're slightly larger and they're formed differently, so they look a little bit differently. So it's all a matter of preference as to what you want to do. If anybody needs to see anything else or would like to see anything else or has any questions, I'm always more than happy to help and create any sort of videos that might help people, because it seems to be a pretty efficient way of doing it. So yeah.